Hello together. So we are ready. It's Tuesday, 12 o'clock for our weekly appointment.
Both freezing.
Mel is freezing. I'm also freezing. I don't know from where you are following us. Maybe you want to write where you are following us from. At least here in Bolzano, it's really cold. When we look out the window, we can see the snow. So let's hope that soon it's cycling time again. At the moment, it's just cold here. But I'm sure that Mel will bring some heat to my body. I hope at least. Okay. So this is week number 9 since we started this nice project of weekly trainings. I hope you are enjoying this, and I hope that you find the time to either follow us live or to do your training afterwards. Should be nice to get some feedback from you if you are able to do this as well. And I have to say, I can start to feel the difference, especially I am starting to really get a routine, and I actually have this elastic band with me all the time wherever I go, and do also in between sometimes just 15 or 20 minutes of training wherever I am, and this is absolutely perfect. So I learned a lot of new exercises with Mel, which I'm really thankful for. What are we doing today?
Today we do a full body workout. So you need one dumbbell, I think 4 to 6 kilo are fine for everybody, and we do a long round, 8 exercises without rest and 4 sets. Okay, and maybe if I don't forget it, between the second and the third set we do our coordination exercise, so we activate our brain.
Okay? Perfect. And one more thing for all the guys that maybe want to train with us, because I got a funny question this week, if actually men are also allowed to train. Of course you are. These workouts are really tough, so they are obviously for everybody. So happy if you join us too.
Okay.
Have fun.
We start. We go to the mat, we do our mobility warm-up. So the warm-up remains more or less the same, so we get the routine also there, warming up. We put our legs to one side, and then we hinge forward with straight back on the exhale. Okay, then we stand in the seated position. Today we don't lift the foot, but we push the foot into the ground and we lift the knee. So it's an extra rotation. Okay, the same thing on the other side. First, we hinge forward, exhale on the way down, and inhale and come back up. Cross, relax, same movement, we push the lower leg towards the ground on the exhale. Keep your shoulders on the ground so you feel more stretch in the back. Switch to the other side. Thank you. try to squeeze your butt on the way up. Stop and turn around. Do a cat and cow. On the exhale, we round our upper back. And on the inhale, we lower our chest and squeeze our shoulder blades. Extend one leg to the side. Keep your back straight and we do little rocks backward. Stay there, put the hand behind the head and do an upper body rotation. On the exhale, we lower the arm. On the inhale, we open up. Switch to the other side first. We rock backwards. Okay, then rotation again. Go. Then we take one big step forward, push your hips forward. On the exhale, the elbow beside your foot goes towards the ground. On the inhale, rotation. Stay like this, put both hands on the ground, with the other knee you go a little bit behind, and then on the exhale extend your leg, keep the hands on the ground so you have more tension on the back side of the leg. Stop, same thing on the other side. Bear hold march, which means you stay like this and we step with both feet backwards and forward again. Keep your upper body stable. Stop. Okay. Then we go bird dog. You extend one arm and the opposite leg on the exhale. Always the same side. Stop, switch to the other side. Stop, perfect. Ready.
Okay.
So, you want to start rotating? Okay. Get warm. You take a dumbbell.
Okay.
Then we do 40, 45 seconds of each exercise, so we are increasing our intensity a little bit.
Going
so this is four, this is five.
Five.
And then we see if we switch. The first exercise is a combo. We do first, I'll show it, we do first a squat, so go low. And then we do a Romanian deadlift. Arms are extended and we push backwards. Then we again squat and Romanian deadlift. Always alternating the exercise. Okay, let's start. Go. Then backwards. Back. Always keeping the back straight. So on the first we work more our quads and our glutes. Second one is more for biceps, femoris and glutes. Doesn't have to be super fast, find the right tempo you like. Switch the other side. Keep the elbow a bit in front of your shoulder. Go. Not in line, but in front of the shoulder. If it's too tough, then keep both legs on the ground. Then we stand up. Put the mat to the side. Again, with the dumbbell. You have two possibilities now. We do. Or we do a squat, and the second one is always a squat jump. Okay? If it's high impact and you need low impact because you have, knee pain or something, you do one squat and the second one is two pulses and then you come back up. Okay, so if possible, then jump. If not possible, then do the pulses. Okay, go. Up and down. And the jump. Oh, always back straight. And when you land, put the heels immediately on the ground. You have to activate your abs and your glutes. If you're not doing it, your hips will tilt to the side. Last one. Stop. And then, next exercise.
I love fun exercise.
Next one is for the abs. We do a fast upper body rotation. The more you put the dumbbell away, the tougher it gets. The nearer, the easier. We do a rotation where we only rotate the upper body, don't use your knees, okay? Okay, go. Bend your knees a little bit and keep the back super straight. Now we do a semi-circle above the head. Okay, from side to side. You can lean a bit forward when the dumbbell goes down. Stop. And the last one is a fast exercise with our dumbbell. First one, we do fast boxing movement with our arms. It doesn't matter if you stay with feet parallel or like this. Try to extend and bend the arms, and when I call the switch, we lower our upper body and we do a running movement. And in both exercises, it's important that when you do this, you don't go from side to side, activate abs and core, so you stay stable. As long as folks. Okay, go. Right, and keep them tight. So it's amazing to Three more sets to go. Second round, if you want to switch dumbbells, you can also switch them from exercise to exercise if you have more than one at home. Good. Right, second round. Again, first the squat, so we lower the body and then we keep the legs quite extended, only bend them a little bit and push backwards. Okay, Marco? Bye. Two times. Oh. Stop. Perfect. Then we do the reverse lunge. We step backwards and we put the dumbbell from side to side. Okay. Go. The knee straight. That's two. Perfect. Then we need the mat. We put one knee on the ground. We do the single arm shoulder press. So the elbow has to stay a bit forward, like 45 degree angle. And from here we push the dumbbell upwards. Okay, Achtung. Go. Activate the abs when you push so you don't move the whole body. Bring the elbow a little bit under your shoulder. Don't put the elbow beside the body. So it's tougher to push. Stop. Okay, the single leg glute bridge. So we lay on our back. And then we extend one leg, and on the exhale we press, go. Thank you. do our squat and squat jump for our squat and squat classes. Here you should feel your quads burning, okay, from the jump. After, go, one more squat, and then we jump. And then the single leg deadlift with the high knee and the front press. Okay. Go, knee forward. On the exhale, high knee and front press. Take your time to stabilize the movement. Maybe stay on one leg. And your knees high. Stop. Okay. Then the rotation for the abs, first from side to side, and then the same circle. After. Go. Relax your shoulders, don't pull the shoulders towards your ears, keep them low. Okay, switch over the head. Okay, left and right, lean a bit forward when you stop the dumbbell. Stop. Perfect. And the last one is the cardio exercise, boxing and swinging the arms. Okay. Achtung. Activate your abs and go.
Repeat the same now, or?
Yeah.
Cool. Do four sets of the same.
Two more.
But first we do the coordination exercise.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Maybe it's not challenging for everybody, but we try it. You extend the thumb of one hand and the pinky of the other one, and then simultaneously you switch.
Don't hurry,
and once you have understood how to do, your body will always repeat it. You can always come back to it. But it's okay. We have to challenge ourselves a little bit. And when we are ready to do this, next time we do another one.
Okay.
So this is the homework you have to If for someone it's easy, you can add something like jumps. Okay, so it's getting tougher because you have to think of two things at the same time.
All right, so we can move on.
Yeah,
I managed to answer. Move on.
Okay, so this is to show you some other things which are important, and not only body stuff, but also concentration, focus, and you have to stay calm and not get too nervous if it doesn't work.
In the head.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, we start with the third round. So after this one, these rounds get easy. Okay, we do again the squat and the Romanian deadlift. Always alternating the movement. Okay, beginning with the squat. Go. Always your knees straight and always the weight on your heels when you squat down. Then we do the reverse lunge, passing the dumbbell from side to side. Okay. Go, step back, lower the body, and pass the dumbbell. You can lean forward, but you have to keep your back straight. Don't bend it too much. On your side. Stop. Perfect. Then we do the press. Single arm, shoulder press. Okay, so grab the dumbbell by the knees on the ground. And then on the exhale, we push. Go. Remember to keep the elbow in front of your shoulder and not in line. And don't move the upper body. So you really work only with shoulder, triceps, traps. Stop. Okay, go to your side. Focus on the hips, keep them parallel to the ground. Go. Stand up, we do the squat jump, we're in power.
classes. The toughest one, I think. Or maybe it's the last one. I don't know. I think from here on, everything is bad. Okay. So, one squat and the second one should be a jump or you pass up and down. Okay. Go. And jump. Straight, and as soon as you touch the ground, you bring also your heels to the floor. Perfect. And the last one again, boxing and then swinging the arms. And pay attention to not move from side to side. Also here, not move, okay? Activate your abs and your glutes. So tilt your pelvis backwards to keep it stable. After boxing. Okay, bye.
Round 3 was tough. 4 would be a killer.
You should change something to keep it always tough.
Yeah.
So maybe if you do this round 1 or 2 times in a week and you feel okay, now it's getting too easy, or you grab more weight, or you do it for 1 minute and not 45 seconds. So you always try to increase a little bit.
Okay.
Then if you have the bad day where you are super tired, then don't do it, okay? Take rest, it's better. Okay, last one.
Yeah.
It's option 5, 6 or more. Okay. Last time, squat and a Romanian deadlift. So, shoulders back and go. Then we do the reverse lunge with the dumbbell that goes from side to side. Okay, step back. Your knees straight, so pay attention to don't move them inwards, okay? Always straight. The elbow goes a little bit for underneath the shoulder, not too much. Stop. Extend one leg and you press. Pay attention not to tilt to the side with the hip. Stop. Stand up. Last three exercises. Squat and squat jump. Okay. Achtung. Ankle. We squat and we jump. Try to keep going even though you're tired. Stop. Perfect. Oh. You should feel a nice burn in the glutes and the quads. And now we do the stability exercise, super tough after a cardio exercise. Okay, here we go. Lean forward. Okay, high knee and front press. Right. stop. And the last one, boxing and running movement of the arms, keeping the body stable. Okay, go. Switch. We did it. So after a few minutes of stretching, and then you can have lunch. You should have lunch.
Yeah, a big hamburger
and fries. To have this stuff, then do it after workouts so you burn it much faster than if you go tonight. So do it at least in between an hour after the workout.
The fries, you mean?
Yeah, yeah, all the
okay.
Stuff. You should
eat. That's good to know. We're not
the fries
here directly. The
and the sweet things. Yeah. Okay, first one for the glutes, which are super tight, I imagine. Yeah. Straight back and push forward. We hold it for 1 minute. You can also, it would even be better to hold it for 2 minutes, but you can do it in front of the TV when you don't know what to do. To relax and use the exhale to push a little bit more forward. After a few seconds you can feel that the tension goes less and then you can push a little bit more. For the back, we put our knees to one side and the arm to the other one. Extend the arm to the opposite side. Instead like this, with a stretch in the back. The more you train, the more you have to do stretching, okay? Because you have more pain when your muscles grow bigger and stronger if you don't keep them
turn around. We stretch the inside of our thighs, so we open up our knees, okay, as much as you can, and then you put the elbows on the ground and you push a little bit backward, so you feel more stretch on the inside. And then hip flexor and quads. One knee stays on the ground. One step forward. Then you plant the foot and put it towards the butt. And then the whole body goes forward. So you feel the stretch in the hip flexor and also the quads. The more you push towards the ground, the more stretch you will feel. And the last one, we stand up for the back side of the legs. We go in a deadlift position. Again, straight back, the butt goes backwards, and then we extend our legs as much as possible and we stay there. Feel the stretch on the back side. So the more you try to arch your back, the more you feel the stretch.
This is Mel, so if you are still hunting for a bikini shape, that's the address.
Okay.
Also, Wenn ihr noch nach der Bikiniform sucht, Mel in Frankfurt bei Bozen, MelFeelingGood Studio, that's where you can get in shape. Thank you for joining. See you next week.
Have a good week.
Tuesday, 12 o'clock.
Bye bye. Thank you.